Hello everyone, Elron here with part 2 of my No Good Needed Dark Souls 1 run. So, I'll probably abbreviate that as NGN for No Good Needed. We have just left the Undead Asylum and we're going to get to Firelink Shrine. Home of the second guy with the second thing with a pet name. First there is Erlenmeyer Flask, now there is Negative Nancy. The crestfallen warrior has been given the nickname Negative Nancy in my circles, namely by me, because of course I didn't bother with wikis, so, you know, nobody ever gives him a name in-game, so I just called him Negative Nancy. Because, I mean, all he does is just sit there and pout about existence. Like a Negative Nancy. So, right now we are looking for the goodies in Firelink. Going to actually drop down here. I think I just noticed out of the corner of my eye an item up there that I totally didn't get, but in the end, all this doesn't really matter too much. I mean, those homeward bones make it worth the trip coming down here, because the way my item duplication glitch works is it doesn't actually duplicate anything. It just takes a consumable that has a yes-no confirmation and lets you use it without consuming it. So, if you have one homeward bone on you, you have infinity homeward bones on you in all senses except for the fact that you can't sell 98 of them to, you know, King Seeker Frampt. Speaking of Frampt, I forget what his pet name was. I'm sure I had one for him. But I guess in the end it doesn't really matter at this point. So, Negative Nancy is going to tell you to go upstairs into Undeadburg and avoid going down the elevator for the time being. And actually, he's kind of wrong. I mean, he's right if you want to not cheese it. But if you're going to go maximum cheese, like I'm going to, you're going to want to ignore him because he's going to lead you astray. The plan is to use that master key that we got as our starting gift and make our way immediately to Valley of the Drakes, which then connects to Stone Root Basin or whatever the forest is, which then connects to Andre the Giant, or I guess Andre the Blacksmith. There we go, another pet name. Funny bit is, there is a giant blacksmith, but the one physically named Andre gets the title giant for whatever reason. But in any case, so I'm talking to everybody and exhausting their dialogues because I actually need their dialogues for a another project that I'll be doing at some point in the future. So I can't just, you know, ignore all these NPCs. I have to actually go through and exhaust their dialogues and get a capture of all of their vocals, so it could be in a nice little song I'm going to make. Um, In Oblivion, there was like the Glarther song and the Imperial Guard song, and stuff like that, where you just pieced together words and made some really cool stuff. And I plan to do that here in Dark Souls with a nice little song of my own. I look forward to doing that, but obviously I don't have the raw materials for it yet, so I'll be holding off on that. And I gotta see if any of my musical folks have any interest in dropping a beat for it. So here we are in New Londo Ruins. Might as well take out a couple hollows down here while we can. I'm starting to think that I might be wrong about this, but I have for months now, ever since my first time down here in New Londo Ruins, have convinced myself that at some point, one of those hollows down here gave me a transient curse, and it was just extremely rare, so I've been compelled to mow them down, when they're on my way to something, just in the off chance that I'll have some transient curses to play with when it's time to finally deal with those crazy ghost wraith thingies that require you to be cursed, otherwise you're just screwed. And trust me, it's pretty bad to be just screwed, so. There is a fire keeper soul pretty early on, and you'd only have to run past a couple of them to get to it. But there's easier ways to get those, and if we're using them only to infinitely duplicate some humanity, then we only need one for now. Ah, yes. So I want to pick up the shield this guy's guarding and make a break for it. But of course, I picked the sword, which was the bad one, and die. But this is a good death. I'm fine with this death, actually. 'Cause that shield was a 100% physical defense shield. And I really don't like messing around with anything less than 100. Unless it serves some extreme utility, like I'm gonna sit around AFK for 5 minutes, I'll put on a Sanctus shield to regenerate my health. Or if I desperately need more stamina regen, I could see going with the Grass Crest. But otherwise, I pretty much mandate using a 100% physical blocking shield. So, as you can see, that dragon's easy enough to run past even when he's awake. So, one death with an easy corpse recovery and an easy skip past later seems to be well worth getting that Dragon Crest shield. And also, if you've got enough upgrading materials, you could situationally use it as a replacement for the Balder shield, if you're fighting something that is going to be heavy on the fire attack side. So I hit this bonfire, but I forget to sit down and rest at it, so when I go and find this Black Knight and realize that I'm being really stupid, I run back and rest at it because I basically forgot that I need a Lord Vessel to teleport. I forget that this isn't Dark Souls 2, where you get that instantaneously. So after wasting a couple pyromancies here, it's like, wait a minute, I can die here, and that would be bad. So, I then go back, and that's gonna be it for this video. I'll see you next video. Good luck, have fun.